Hello and welcome to Circuit Crush TV. I'm your host, Brian Jenkins, and today I have two lamps. These are touch lamps, and they both work. The situation is, here with this one, the shade broke a long, long time ago, so it has no shade. This one here has a shade. I removed it because I don't want to scratch it. But the problem with this lamp here is it seems to come on by itself all of a sudden. So I suspect that the touch module in the base of the lamp could be faulty. This one doesn't do that and it works. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to do a hack. I'm going to cannibalize this lamp here without the shade. I'm going to remove the touch module and transplant it into this lamp. Now, I've already removed the bottom plate. There was felt and then this metal plate. And you can see the module right here. And it says Zing Ear TP-01 touch light control for incandescent lamp only. Okay, and this guy had a piece of felt on the bottom. I removed the felt, and there's just two screws. I'll remove the other screw here real quickly. A few more turns. There we go. And we can see that it's a similar module. I should just be able to just cut these wires and then transplant the good one into here. And then maybe even troubleshoot this thing. I'm not sure what's inside of the box, but it'd be interesting to find out. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do this hack. I'm going to swap these modules and put this one into here, and then we're going to see if it works. So I don't want to bore you with, you know, having to watch me like cut these wires and wire it up, but it's pretty straightforward, looks to me. Here we have, let's see, the lamp cord, one of them goes to the black wire. And then the other one to the red. And then we have this white wire here. So if I have to, I could probably go online and get the specs on these things, because it's not clear immediately which one of these wires is neutral, which is hot, and if it matters. But I'm gonna go ahead and try to swap these, and I'll get back to you guys and let you know how things go.
Okay, so I'm back, and I wanted to do a little research about this module online. And here we can see the wiring diagram I wanted to show you guys real quick before I actually went and made the switch. We have the white line coming out of the module goes to the lamp, and then the red line goes to the lamp also that completes the circuit, and it gets hooked to the hot on the 120 AC. Now, if you try something like this, of course, be careful. Goes without saying that you want to unplug it first and that you want to make sure you wire it right. It is 120 volts AC, and it can be dangerous. And then here we have the black line. We can see that this goes to the neutral from the cord coming into the lamp. So really, it's just a matter of kind of matching colors here and looking at, since the lamp cord itself doesn't have any color, I mean, they're both the same color, rather. You can't really tell by looking at them which is hot and which is neutral. But we can see here when we look at this diagram and at the actual lamp itself with the module attached to it, it's pretty easy to tell which one is the hot and which one is the neutral. So we're going to go ahead, we're going to cut back to the other camera and do the switch.
Okay, so I'm back over here, and I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to remove this module from this lamp. But I want to remove it carefully. I don't want to clip these leads too short. So I got my trusty electrician's pliers from the last video, and I'm going to cut these connectors off. There you go. Because again, I want to keep these leads as long as I can. It's just good practice. So I'm going to try to keep those nice and long. I'm just going to trim off these crimp-on connectors. Yeah, they're going to go all over the floor. And then this yellow wire, we can see this is what senses it when you touch it. This is actually connected to the metal frame of this lamp. So I'm going to have to try to unscrew this guy a little bit here, get him out. Let's see if I can get that with my fingers now. Broke it loose. Yeah, that's gonna come right off. And then here is that terminal. And this is the lamp cord. I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of this because it's really kind of in the way. So I'm gonna untie that, pull that right through. Now it's gone. Remove that nut. And it looks like, okay. There's a little piece on top I'm turning. A little nipple, they call that a nipple. It's kind of funny. All right, and here we have it. Here is the good module. I'm gonna go ahead and remove the old one from that other lamp and then get this guy hooked up. And I'm just gonna do it one wire at a time. That way I don't have to think too hard about which wire goes where, and I'll make sure that it's wired right. Okay, here we are again, and I have a couple tools with me that I'm gonna need. I'm gonna need wire strippers to strip the ends off of here. I'm gonna keep these because I gotta turn that nut off and then put it back on. And I need the crimper so I can crimp on the new connectors. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna start by stripping this wire back, these two. And I'm thinking that I might wanna connect this yellow wire to the lamp first. That way that's out of the way, and then I can worry about crimping these guys on. So I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna disconnect this yellow one. Of course, the way your lamp is put together may vary, but this thing needs to make contact with the metal body of the lamp to work. Let's see if I can grab it with the ends of this and turn it. There we go. That's actually easier than using those clines to turn that nut. These wire strippers have a little tiny grip on the end of them that you can use, and let's get that with my finger. And, okay. So I see the situation here. That washer needs to stay. I need to cut these wires off. So what I'm going to do is take one at a time, same procedure we used before, cut it off. Strip it. There's the lamp cord that's inside of the lamp, strip that back. And I'm just going to remember that these have to go together. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to temporarily just kind of connect these. Now here, I have to cut this one off. I don't want to get these two confused. So let's see. Let's see if I can find a way to mark this. I have a, in my drawer here that you probably can't see, it's a whiteout pen. And you could use a marker, anything, paint, whatever you happen to have lying around. Of course I wouldn't use a black marker because the wire's black. But I'm gonna mark the one connected to the white wire. I'm gonna mark it white with this whiteout pen. There we go, that way there's no confusion about which wire goes where. I know that this one that's not marked goes with these two, the red, and then here. And I know that the white just goes with the white. So let's cut him off. And now we can remove this. Get our new one back on here. slip this nut back on first, because this is gonna make it easier if I do it that way. Here we go. Now, just have to try to screw this back together. This actually holds the lamp together too, so I'm gonna make that nice and tight. Alright. Now, remember that we're splicing white to white. So I'm gonna strip the white wire here and then strip this guy back a little bit. I'm gonna twist them together. The old module. Well, I feel stupid. Okay, try that again. Okay, so I got those twisted together. And I'm going to be careful not to confuse the old module with the new. But I'm going to take lamp cord, this other black wire, and the red wire from our transplant that we're using, and I'm going to twist these three together. As you can see, I have one more wire to connect, but before I go any further, I'm going to crimp that on. So let me find the appropriate size crimp on nut here. This is actually a bag that has a variety of sizes in it. I want to try to find something similar to what's already there. That's a little smaller. Don't want it to be too big. Now this one might be sufficient, the smaller one, for crimping these just two wires together. This is just two wires. And I'm going to go ahead and use my crimp tool. I'm going to make sure that's on nice and tight, because remember, we're dealing with 120 volts AC here. Could be dangerous. We don't want any trouble, okay? And I want to make sure that this is... connected correctly. And since I have three wires instead of two, I might go for a little bit bigger connector. Can I get away with a small one? Actually, I might be able to get away with a small one. Let's see. Go ahead and put that right on. And I'm going to give these connections a quick tug to make sure that they don't slip off. But we'll make our last connection here. Cut that off. Take the old module out. Set it aside. Strip that. Pigtail them together. Crimp on connector on there. Okay. Now, I've reconnected the good touch module, and before I even bother putting, you know, the base back on and stuffing these, you know, the module and the wires in here and putting that plate back on in the felt, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to plug this in to 120 AC, and I'm going to be very careful about this, but I want to test this thing. So I have an outlet strip over here you guys probably can't see, but first I have to get at least one light bulb. And it does say incandescent bulbs only, so I probably wouldn't want to use LED or CFL bulbs when it says incandescent bulbs only. Okay, so here's a moment of truth. I have a bulb put in, and I have this plugged into 120-volt source. And we see when I touch it, there are three levels of brightness. So it does appear to be working. Whether or not this thing will kick on by itself again, I doubt it, because I changed the module. But we'll just have to wait and see. But this is it. I'm going to go ahead and put the lamp back together, finish that. I won't bore you guys with that stuff. But as you can see, we have what appears to be a successful hack.